This is Lloyd Moss welcoming you to a very special event recorded at Carnegie Hall, where pianists have gathered from around the world to perform in an international celebration of the piano. This television program has been prepared exclusively for the Arts and Entertainment Network. Our international celebration of the piano begins with a performance by Jean-Yves Thibaudet. Jean-Yves Thibaudet, a native of Lyon, France, began studying the piano at the age of 5 and gave his first public performance at 7. When he was 17 years old, he was awarded the highest prize at the International Piano Competition in Tokyo. Mr. Thibaudet will play the 24th Chopin Prelude in D minor. Leon Bates, a native of Philadelphia, began his musical studies at age 6 on both piano and violin. A favorite with North American audiences, he recently served as a State Department specialist on tour in Zimbabwe. Mr. Bates gives us the last movement from Ravel's famous Sonatine of 1905. Barbara Nissman is well known for her interpretations of the music of Alberto Ginastera. She made her New York Philharmonic debut playing the Ginastera Concerto No. 1, and the composer dedicated his third piano sonata, his last work, to her. Now, Barbara Nissman plays two of the three Argentine dances written by Ginastera when he was only 19.
Thank you.
Stephen Hough is one of England's finest young concert pianists. He is a frequent guest of the London Symphony, Philharmonia Royal, and London Philharmonic. We now hear Mr. Hough play a beautiful Paderewski Nocturne in B-flat. Grant Johannesen, one of our country's most distinguished artists, is frequently guest soloist with the New York Philharmonic and the Boston Symphony. Mr. Johannesen treats us to the unusual delights of Stravinsky's tango. Here is Grant Johannesen. Navah Perlman began to study piano at the age of 6. When she was 12 years old, she made her professional debut playing the Haydn Concerto in D major. We're delighted to present Navah Perlman playing The Street Awakening from Prokofiev's own piano transcription of his immortal ballet, Romeo and Juliet. Alexander Toradze was born in the Soviet Union. He entered the Moscow Conservatory in 1971, and 6 years later won the silver medal in the Van Cliburn competition. He emigrated to the United States in 1983. Mr. Toradze dedicates to the memory of his close friend, the pianist Yuri Egorov, this performance of Domenico Scarlatti's D minor sonata. Thank you. Jerome Rose is a recipient of the Franz Liszt Medal from the Hungarian Ministry of Culture and a winner of the grand prize at the Busoni competition. Mr. Rose will play number 2 of Clara Wieck Schumann's Davidsbündler Tanze. David Dubal has performed throughout the United States and recently in Korea, where he gave master classes at Seoul National University. He is author of 2 recent books, Reflections from the Keyboard and The Art of the Piano, and a contributing editor to the Piano Quarterly. Mr. Dubal plays Anton Rubinstein's Romance in E-flat Major. Thank you. Alexis Weissenberg gained international prominence after winning the Levantritt Award, America's most prestigious musical honor. His discography includes more than 50 recordings, and he is a recipient of a gold record for the sale of over 1 million albums. Now, the Bulgarian virtuoso Alexis Weissenberg plays the Tchaikovsky Rachmaninoff Lullaby. Christopher O'Reilly has captured top prizes at many of the world's most prestigious piano competitions, including the Montreal, the Leeds, the Busoni, and the Van Cliburn. Mr. O'Reilly continues the time-honored tradition of transcription with his own arrangement from Leo Delibes' opera, Lakmé. Thank you. We certainly hope you've enjoyed this special program, an international celebration of the piano, recorded at Carnegie Hall in New York. Now, this is Lloyd Moss, on behalf of A&E, thanking you for being with us.